Grove State Park is a beautiful coastal property boasting miles of coastline and thousands of acres of wildlife. But behind all that is Crystal Cove Conservancy. With over 46 cottages, there are 17 left to restore. Laura Davick has history here at Crystal Cove, and she is here to tell us about the preservation of the 17 cottages that you see here behind us. Well, thank you for having us. I really appreciate it, and so much work to be done.
Yes, we do have our work cut out for us here. As you mentioned, these are the final 17 cottages here at Crystal Cove. We also call this a Heritage Legacy Project for California. This really is the last piece of Crystal Cove, and we are committed to seeing this through. You might ask where we're at right now. It's quite a large project for an organization like ourselves, but we've made some significant progress. So I'd like to describe the project to you if I could. Okay, the project will be completed in two steps. First, we'll come in and we'll do the infrastructure portion of the project, and then come back in and do the second part, which is the restoration. So we have to stabilize some bluffs, we have to put in all utilities, underground lift stations, and then a 650-foot boardwalk that will come down the entire front of this project. There really is no public access here. But what this does for this park is this serves as a catalyst to really help us bridge that gap and inspire others in this community to step forward. This is truly a legacy project, and I'm actually, I'm the campaign chair of this project. I personally have made a five-year pledge for this project, and I'm asking others in the community to consider joining us in doing so, so that we can begin this project and hopefully start construction before the end of this year. So for more information about this, you can go to our website, and you can always go to crystalcove.org under Support North Beach Restoration to find out where we're at. So it's an exciting project, it's an exciting time for our organization, and we couldn't be more thrilled with this new opportunity.
So if people want to participate, how would you recommend they do that?
Well, first of all, they can do that anytime throughout the year in a variety of ways, either by making a donation or making a pledge to the project. Also, we are very much interested in planned gifts, estate gifts, any number of ways. And you can learn all about how to be part of this project by going to our website. And I have to tell you why this is important, because this truly is, I think, one of Orange County's most iconic destinations, right? This is a place like no other. It's the last intact example of early vernacular architecture, which basically means a seaside community that was built without architects or without plans. It's also on the National Register of Historic Places, and it's one of California's newest historic landmarks. Beyond that, it's this project here that creates the sustainable future for this entire park. And people may say, well, how do you do that? And that's based upon our long-term contract that we have of investing proceeds back into this park. So we will be maintaining all of these cottages once completed, just like we do the rest of the cottages. And then the surplus revenues will go back into the park and back to us to expand our education and conservation programs. So it is imperative that we save these final 17 cottages. And we're so close. And I have to say, we're so grateful to so many that have come before us to help. And so this is our last big final push.
Well, just think about it. If you have 17 more cottages, that means you might not have to wait 6 months to get one.
Well, it will double the overnight rental capacity here. So it will actually add 24,000 additional heads on pillows. And in addition to that, we have an education program that's developing, which is all about coastal engineering. So one of the cottages on the North Beach will actually be a dorm that students can come down to and have a two-night stay here. So we're working with UCI and also the Henry Samueli School of Engineering to develop programs that will educate students and the general public about all the issues affecting the coastline of California. So it's a win-win for everybody, and everybody loves Crystal Cove. And so we're just asking, if you do love Crystal Cove, come on down, learn more about what we're doing. I do a public tour the third Sunday of every month from 12 to 2. And you can come down and learn about all of the things that are wonderful here at Crystal Cove.
And- and it's not a bad place to be. I mean, it is just gorgeous here. Thank you for having us. Good luck to you, and congratulations on everything that you've done up to this point.
Well, thank you. We have a great big group of people that are working to see this through, but we do need people in the community to come forward at this time for this final leg. So thank you for this opportunity, and we hope to see everyone here at Crystal Cove.
All right. Well, I know you'll see us back. Thank you.